All of my let's just be friends, friends I don't have anymore. How do you not check on me when things go wrong? Guess I should have tried to keep my family closer.
I'm the best DB trainer, I promise you that.
You sit and you pray, hoping that the stars align. My luck is a sure thing, cause I'm living right. When I needed you, you couldn't give me any advice. You always had something to say every other time. Everybody there met on the way, tries to get in the way. I'm fooling and serving them all like I work for minimum wage. Someone up there must just love testing my patience. Someone up there must be in need of some meditation.
Nobody knows what it's like to be in your situation, that you gotta keep going, bro. And that's it. Don't just go through the motions. Still be intentional. Still believe. Still see the vision, bro. You gotta keep going. You don't know what's on the other side of this, bro. You gotta keep planting those seeds, and you gotta keep going, bro. God did not bring you this far to leave you.
Back at the crib, bro. XFL draft happened yesterday. Didn't get picked up. But you know what? I promise, man. All these videos gonna come together and make something one day. You know, God gonna work something out. I'm gonna continually do my part, continually put in this work, continually trust the process, continually trust my process that I've developed, that people have helped me formulate, and continue to get better. I'm gonna check back in with y'all real soon, but just keep working, man. Keep pressing, man. We're not at the goal yet, man. We're not at the goal. We haven't reached the goal. Just stepping stones. All right, peace.
Okay. I got it now. You saying don't just touch. Okay. But I didn't know, bro. I got it now, though. What? He's acting different for the camera, bro.
I knew one of y'all was going
to
say that.
Two in, two out. T-stepping. We're going to be on the hex from here on out. Make sure, hey, we get two in, two out, T-stepping, so it's gonna be that left foot T-step every single time. Turn it over. Don't tuck.
We're going.
Hey, man, burst. Hey, just give me a quick burst. I don't want you in the middle of the field, I want you all over there.
Chainbreaker.
We're going left. As soon as you get over, start with the right. On that hit, we're going to take it off. Got this, then we come back and go on the other side. Here we go. A little bit, gotta keep your hands up here and okay. Consistently pedal here.
you want to sit out here too much. So okay. Get up here, push back. Let the quads work, let our feet work, okay? All right. So here we go. We're going to tell y'all, we're going to stay down there. I'm coming down there to bring you back. Here we go. Set, go. It's very light, very light.
First step?
No, just that, the rake. Let's get out of the rake. Let the feet stay flat. Let your cleats graze the grass. Okay. As I told y'all before, we don't need to be a boat that's trying to take off with our anchor down. That's all we're doing. If our toe in the ground, that's the anchor, and we can't go anywhere. That's resisting us. Stay flat-footed to push off the balls of our feet. Here we go. Scoot left one, right there. Push off, go. Push, push, graze, graze, graze.
Yeah.
Take it there. Here we go. Stay there. Stay there. Push. Come on. Pedal over to our right. Stay zone. Stay zone. Hit and come back. Okay? The ball can be dropping. The ball can be right at your chest. The ball can be high a little bit, okay? I don't owe you a good ball.
Came to a complete stop.
Yes.
Yeah, because that hop.
Don't do that. Run through the ball and leap with your athleticism. You don't want to come to a complete stop because you come to a complete stop, what are the receivers still doing?
Run
it. You can't think because the game is going to be a lot faster. So, if the game a lot faster, that means you're going to run a lot what?
Faster.
Run a lot faster. So as you're pushing there, if you go to cup that ball and you don't catch it clean with your hands, guess what's going to knock it out?
Honey.
You're going to knock it out. Grab water real quick. We're going to hatch.
Part of the process, though, man, because every day not going to be great. I'm trying to go after whatever you're trying to get, Russ. Every process not going to be great. Every day not going to be great. Keep coming back. No, I got a lot of work to do. You know what type of player I need to be. Who I want to be, where I want to go. So I'm going to keep putting the days on top of days, keep getting better. I know there's strengths to my game, there's weaknesses to my game. Continue to hone in on the strengths, you know, make those my strong points, and then all the weaknesses, you know, you just got to continue to work on them. So it's a little thing. I know I dropped a bunch of dropped much on today. Bad reads. Comes with it. You just reset, stay neutral. You know, level minded. Don't acknowledge it too much and keep going.
Oh my gosh, bro!
Everybody has their own. And I think the purpose in this whole entire series is y'all watching me go after what I want. I'm gonna continually show people in my life, people that I run into, whether it's this USFL league, which I'm very grateful for the Lord opening up that door, because I know I'm gonna take advantage of it and perform and do what I need to. But as I said in the last episode, you know, it's been a lot of dark, lonely nights, and
My man Marlo been with me the whole time through this, and he kind of catching the tail end, but I'm sending him the videos. He's kind of seeing the process. He sees, you know, 2016, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. I mean, we're in 2022 right now. Still not there, but, you know, it feels like every time it gets dark, God still opens up a way. You know, every year I've been, since I've came out, it's been some of these leagues. It was the AAF, it was the XFL, it was the Spring League. Now it's the USFL. And it's crazy, you think, like, for all them years beforehand, 2017, 18, 16, bro, there ain't never been there's never been any other leagues. And it's like, how ironic for it to be at this time when I need it the most, or when other people, not just me, but like when other individuals need that opportunity, but it coincides so perfectly with mine, because had these opportunities not been here, I'm gonna be honest, I probably wouldn't even be able to get the opportunity to continue to go through going through an ACL and through going through injury. The pro day itself would have been cool, but it may not have given me the opportunity the way that these opportunities have. And I'm gonna continue to show more and more people through my journey that are trusting their seed, because that's what it's about.
When you look at this, I think we all have our own plans. And, you know, so many men and women, we go about life, going to school, thinking this way is going to be the way. And in our reality, that's our way. That's not God's way. God's way is a little different than ours. His ways are not our ways. His thoughts are not our thoughts. And so, you know, for me, it's been amazing to be on this journey with so many different athletes, but in particular, Tarp, like, I'm able to kind of see him grow. Like, never in a million years did I ever think I'll be here, right? And after my day's plan, I was going through a season of trying to figure out where I'm supposed to be. And this is exactly where I'm supposed to be. My plans were, I had all kind of different plans, but it's just one of those things where, you know, God just opens your eyes and you see where your passion is. And when you got a passion for that, you know, training, and I always thought my gift was football. No, that was my talent. My gift is pouring into men. And, you know, my opportunity here with Tarp, and obviously with Drian, and somebody who I've built a close relationship with, who coaching and training him and watching him play, watching him succeed, watching Tarp go and just be, just attack, you know, what he wants and how he feels God is leading him. I mean, this is just awesome for me. And so the only thing that we can do is, you know, we can plant the seed, but God can give an increase. We can water, we can do all, God gives the increase. And so it's I'm excited to see where God has taken him, where God has taken so many other athletes that I get a chance to pour into. But once again, I don't get the glory, God get it. I'm just having fun doing it.
I mean, just trying to, I mean, kind of building off what B said, man, just football, just coming out of a small school, you know, not really having too many pro opportunities, to finally getting an opportunity to play an indoor, and, you know, just meeting somebody like B, man, who's just a man of God, and, you know, just show me what faith and just hard work is about, man. So, I mean, just out here trying to water that seed, man.
When this does come to light, when the fruition fully blossoms, when I figure out, you know, what type of seed I am, and I get there, the story is crazy, and I just want people to be able to go back and watch all these, almost like a movie, you know, be able to see everything from the beginning, you know, from when I got hurt. It's not really about what's inside of, you know, with the training and stuff. That's cool. That's just complimentary to show people the consistency. Like, yo, he's working. He's up every day at 4 a.m., right? He's getting to it. He's training 4 or 5 times a week, remaining consistent, doing what he needs to do, putting in speed work, position work, field work. And it's not perfect. Like today, I didn't have a great day, and it's always going to be perfect. There's no way you can have every day be perfect, but if you keep just getting better and better every single day, it's going to eventually happen. So those individuals that look at it, they can just keep going and keep grinding, and they see other people talking about how they're trusting seed, because you're not the only person out here. So, man, y'all remain faithful, continue to trust the Lord. Yeshua, he's our way, he's our light, he's our lamp. So continue to trust him and remain faithful.